What's up, Wolfpack fam? Hope everyone is doing well. We will be continuing our journey of Max and Patty. This is going to be episode 2, boys and girls. Very excited. I know we're in for a good laugh, and you know, we're gonna just dive right into it. So let's get it. Yeah. Max and Patty adventures start right now. Let's get it.
Max and Patty's Road to Nowhere, sponsored by Chorley FM, where the listener comes first.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear a word they're saying.
Streets.
Only the echoes of my mind.
Thanks,
people stop and stare. I can't see their faces. Only the shadows of their eyes. I'm going where the sun keeps shining. Suits my clothes. Banging off of the northeast winds, sailing on summer breeze, and skipping over the ocean.
Paddy, is it? That is me. Let me at him. Follow me, son. Just slip into these, will you? Rest of your costume's hanging up. I like it, I like it. Little bit of role play. Okay, well, rest it Castor in there. You get your gear on, and I'll get camera set up.
10-4.
Hey, don't let me down, cock.
Right then, who's first?
Willy Wanker and the Chocolate Factory, take one.
Don't know where we're going, got no way of knowing, driving on the road to nowhere. Sponging for a living, checking out the women, riding on the road to nowhere. And we don't take shit from anyone. The only thing we want to do is have some fun. We're Max and Patty.
Patty and Max.
And best of all, we don't pay council tax.
Willy Wonka. Ooh, sore.
You all right? How'd it go? Well, what happened?
I'd rather not talk about it, if you don't mind. And go easy over these speed bumps.
Nice and sore, guys.
Oh, what's that?
Oh, Jesus, something's blown. Something, pull in here. I can't believe this.
Nothing!
Gasket's gone! He's pissing oil here! That's
not good. Hey! There's luck would have it!
Need a bit of help, boys!
Do we?
Mick Bustin's the name!
Well?
There's shit in your carburetor.
Who's done that?
Is the gasket pissing oil?
Yeah.
What did that tell you?
She's been screwed. I'll tell you that for three.
Well, can you fix it?
We busy. Leave it with me. I'll get stuck up for this afternoon.
Dude, that looks like freaking, Slade from the Christmas thing that we reacted to. Holy shit, is that, that's that? I'm freaking impressed right now.
So what do you want to do now?
Well, technically, Patrick, we're homeless. Why don't we spend the afternoon in the countryside? Enjoy the rather clement weather. Go for a walk.
I'd sooner spend it in a brothel.
Oh, no, you wouldn't. Ooh. I'll get me shorts.
Oh, please, God, not the cream-coloured hot pants.
Beautiful, Patrick. Breathe it in. You can't buy this, son.
Middlewood? Middlewood? We're in the middle of a wood.
No, we're not. We're in God's back garden.
Hang on. Let's wake Job up here.
Work it out.
Hang on. That can't be right.
What?
That were it. That were the last train.
And what time's the next one?
Tomorrow. That's when the next one is. 07:13 hours in the AM, eh? What's going on?
Thatcher's Britain. There's only one thing for it, then. We'll have to ramble. We'll have to walk. Let's get ready to ramble. Let's get ready to walk. Let's get ready to ramble. Come on, let's get ready to walk.
You're loving this, aren't you?
Oh, I.
Let's go. Roughing it?
I'm shattered. He knocks you out of this country, doesn't he?
2 hours we've been at it.
Go on, it's your turn.
Right, Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da. Da-da-da-da.
Da-da-da-da. Boom, boom. Da-da-da-da. Da-da-da-da. The A-team.
Let's go.
Yeah. I'll tell you who my favourite in the A-team. Howling Mad Murdoch. Oh. I did some laughing at him. Hey. They were crackers.
You can't beat BA though, eh?
You reckon?
Oh, I ain't getting on no plane, fool. I ain't getting on no plane.
Yeah. Here, drink this milk, BA. Oh.
How'd I get here?
Yeah. every week, yeah.
Tell you another one of my favourites.
Who's that?
Mammy Vice. Crockett and Tubbs, eh? I muddled myself on those two chances.
I'll tell you a couple of blokes that'll put them in the shade.
Who?
Magnet and Steel.
Who?
Magnet and Steel? Eh?
I don't remember them. When were that on?
They've never been on. You know why? I've created them.
You what?
I've made them up. They're a couple of cops who operate outside the law. And when there's trouble, they come together.
Don't tell me. Like Magnet and Steel.
Exactly. Yeah. I thought up a while back now. Take a look at these. 6 years' work here, Patrick.
Holy shit.
These are some drawings I've done of them. There's our helicopter, Magnet Steel's helicopter. He got rockets on the helicopter, he got lasers out front. Get him, Magnet. Bang. I'm evil. He's chasing him in a tank, look.
And who's drawn these? You?
Yeah. That's Frank Magnet, Tony Steel.
Is he Chinese?
No, I only had a yellow felt tip. There's some weapons that they use. Sword. One's got a knife. We've got a super gun. He's got one of them's got X-ray glasses. He makes them in a secret laboratory.
Fantastic.
This is good.
Yeah. Magnet and Steel, Paddy. You saw it here first, my friend.
Sold.
Magnet and Steel. The next big thing.
Sold, baby. Pretty creative, right? 18 like shit.
Let's face it, we're lost.
How can we be lost if we don't know where we are?
There's no country pubs up here. I'm going back, mate.
You can't go back. It's too far and it'll be dark soon.
What do you suggest we do?
Well, let's get down here for night.
Sorry, for a second there, I thought you were actually suggesting we sleep in the woods.
You've never been in the armed forces, have you, Patrick?
Neither have you.
Have I not? I used to cry myself to sleep every night in the Yemen, dreaming of digs like this. Now, come on, go and get some bracken and someone. We'll get a fire going. We can do this. Come on.
You are on your arse.
I'm worried for them. It ain't as easy.
That's it. Come on. Bloody hell, where have you been?
I got lost. It's like the Blair Witch out there, you know. Any joy?
Oh, the hands are red raw. I can't see a bastard thing here.
Oh, come
on. Come on.
Any better?
Bloody hell, right there. This prick.
I'll go and get some more twigs.
Oh shit, that's so fucked up. 6 years. I'd be pissed, man.
See? And that's a fire. I told you to enjoy yourself, didn't I? Oh yeah, it's gonna be good, this. What's that you're burning?
Uh-oh. He's gonna be pissed, man.
I can't believe you burnt me drawings.
I'm sorry. I didn't realise you were being serious.
Yeah, well, you better sleep with one eye open tonight, son, Jamie. Ah! Bloody stinging nettles.
I told you not to put them shorts on.
Well, I didn't know we were going to be sleeping out here, did I? Eh, smart ass?
All right, all right. Keep your shorts on. I'm hungry. I said I'm hungry. Are you hungry?
I'm not speaking to you.
God, I said I'm sorry. If you could have something sweet now, I bet I know what it would be. Your favourite. Chicken Kiev, chips, beans, and a fried egg. Am I right?
Sounds good.
And what about bringing it to you through those trees there? A couple of naked women.
Okay.
And I mean naked. There's your meal, sir, and here's your dessert. Ding dang do.
What's the dessert?
Whatever you desire.
Can I have Angel Delight?
Angel Delight.
You can have whatever you want. It's your fantasy. Only I won't be joining you. I once kissed a girl at a Chicken Kiev. She stunk. I fired her off after that.
She could have been the girl of your dreams, Patrick.
No. Not with those teeth.
Ew.
You've really no respect for women, have you?
No. Do you know why? Because they only want you for one thing. Everything.
You've never been in love, have you, Patrick? And I'm talking about real love now. When you feel it here.
I've felt it here. Oh, I've felt it here, my friend.
Not there, here, in your stomach. When love comes, it's like a little butterfly. Soft and gentle as a sigh.
Bollocks, when have you been in love?
It was a while ago now. Tina, she were called. I'll never forget it. It was New Year's Eve.
Potter had booked a mandroid.
Techno, 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 techno.
The regulars weren't happy. They were expecting Nucky Burr.
Techno, 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 techno.
Anyway, I saw her up against bar, nearly threw her out for underage drinking.
Hey! You shouldn't. Oh, I do apologise, I'm sorry. I thought you were underage and you shouldn't be in here.
Underage? Why? How old was she, you dirty dog?
Techno, 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 techno.
Oh, she were old enough.
It's just that she was,
What?
She was a kind of midget.
Ain't that a Queen song?
No, you clown.
What, do you mean she were a dwarf?
No, she wasn't a dwarf, she was a midget.
Like there's a difference?
There is, actually, Mr. Politically Incorrect. Dwarfs, for your information, are in the circus and do cartwheels.
Jesus.
Whereas midgets are like normal human beings, but shrunk down.
Oh, shit.
You live and learn.
Jesus.
Anyway, we just got talking, you know, chatting about anything and everything. I couldn't believe it when she told me. It turned out we both went to the same school. Only I were a few years above her.
And a few feet.
Careful.
Sorry. Carry on.
It were getting towards the midnight hour. And the drink was flowing, you know how it is.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, whoa, 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 I said New Zealand, didn't I? You great big tit. Get it off him. Get it off. I do apologise. Get it off him.
Should all acquaintance be forgot?
Cheer for brains. I said don't use your linen tap.
That was when we first kissed.
Any good?
Little butterfly.
Aww. Not a nickname.
Thin ice.
Sorry. Just a little fun.
Look, son, it's what's in the heart that matters, not the height.
Just hang on while I throw up.
You wanted me to tell you, didn't you?
All right, sorry, go on.
We started courting after that.
How old?
We saw each other every day, went everywhere together. But it wasn't easy. People stirring and laughing behind our backs. And there's only so many people you can thump.
Cockles! Mussels!
Shrimp!
She's too small, I've told you.
Love is just like a merry-go-round with all the fun of the thing. One day I'm feeling down on the ground, then I'm up in the air.
You see, Tina, she'd had it all her life, but it was a whole new world for me. Times like that, Patrick, you've got to take your hat off to Cranky's. I don't know where those two coped. I'd had it up to here.
Don't you mean there?
That's it. Look, what you don't understand, Patrick, is that I've heard it all before, and most of it from my so-called friends.
Who? Boys?
I was on the door one night. Evening. I'm in the crack with the lads. You know how it is.
Dead.
Nicola Fowler in.
Bloody hell, you're not still seeing her, are you?
Yeah, why?
She's seen more pricks in a second-hand dartboard, that girl.
180!
Exactly.
You can talk. At least I'm not banging one at borrowers. Where's China Tina, Thumbelina?
She'll be at home, trying to reach the door handle. Can't get out. Hey, she bought a book. How to make yourself taller. She stood on it.
Oh, man. Hey, I hear she was in the Midget Olympics.
Go on.
Compact discus thrower.
Yeah. Ruthless. She got the bronze in the short jump.
Jesus, Max, why didn't you stop them?
I wanted to, I really did, but you know what it's like when lads are having a laugh.
Good job Tina didn't hear you.
She did. She was listening round the corner. She heard it all.
She locked herself in the budgie cage when she was cleaning it.
Yeah, door slammed shut on her. I got myself a crying,
talking,
sleeping,
walking,
living doll. I'm gonna do the best to please her just cause she's a living doll. Hey, Max, I bet she goes up on you, don't she?
Too far, Tony! I'd had enough. When I got back to my mum's after she'd already been round with a letter.
Saying what?
It was over. She said she thought I was different, but I was just like all the rest. I went round for to see her after that, but she'd gone. Moved away. I've never seen her since. I had it all and I blew it. Word of advice, Patrick. Don't make my mistake. When you find something or somebody that you love, don't let it go. And don't let anybody or anything get in the way.
It's gonna make me cry, man. And laugh.
Good night, son.
He was in love, man. Nina.
Bloody hell. I'm hungry now.
What do you want? Twix fudge or curly whirly?
Where do you get them from?
24-hour garage.
Where?
Kidding me?
I don't believe it.
The irony.
Is she ready?
She is!
Wasn't easy. We've sweated like a couple of pregnant nuns on that thing.
What, changing a gasket?
A gasket? That was the tip of the iceberg, that duck. It was like opening Pandora's box, opening that bonnet.
How much?
500.
500? 500 pound or pence? Let me have a look at it.
Whoa! Oh, yeah, I finished yet.
Oh, you finished? Give us the keys.
I wish I could, me old duck. But it ain't quite as simple as that.
Look, buddy, I'm tired. I've not changed my underpants. Give me the keys, or I'll be doing a bit of busting. Mick, busting.
Shit. And I'll do your dentist a favour and knock them bastards out. Capiche?
Les? Dennis? Like I said, 500 or she's going nowhere.
Oh, so that's the way you want to play it, is it? Prison rules. Okay, well, don't worry. We'll be back. We'll be back.
We're open till 6.
Ghostbusters.
It's locked.
You don't say.
Round the back.
Break that shit.
Come on. The window.
Rick, give us a peg up.
Hey, this could be a job for Magnet and Steel, this.
Just come on. What's a freak?
Oh, God.
To close this down, guys, we are going to be going full screen again. See you in a sec. Oh man, guys, so we are back at it, and I am probably never ever gonna think about Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory ever again. Yeah, only Patty would get himself involved in something so crazy like that. You know, he'd be looking in the advertisements in those newspapers and shit, you better be reading the fine print. So, you know, Patty definitely, his like sense of humor, I could definitely say I have a very similar sense of humor to his sense of humor, especially when Max is talking about love for a second, and he's like, yeah, I'll feel it right here. And you know where he's pointing at, you know, just that silly kind of thing. So it's interesting, though, because sometimes, you know, characters, you can very, very much relate to them, or they've got similar personalities. So to me, Max and Patty, the two perfect complementary characters with, you know, their duo, you know, they just gel. It's like peanut butter and jelly, just bam, just perfect. And, you know, just seeing him in the opening, you know, with that silly outfit, you knew it was going to be some weird shit, but I was hoping he was going to get, you know, later some shit. But yeah, you know, he definitely had a life experience there. So very funny scene right there. The music, exceptional. When you're seeing the, what is it, bobblehead, or, you know, almost called it a Funko Pop for a second. You see the bobblehead with, you know, Mr. T, a pretty the fool. I freaking loved A-Team. Never got to see the whole thing growing up, but definitely a show that my folks enjoyed very much. So I was fortunate enough to see a couple of the episodes. I should watch it on my free time just to see it. But very A-Team vibes on this episode. Mic busting. I think it's mic busting. You know, the Ghostbuster kind of logo of it, very cool. You're hearing the music kind of. So again, music's definitely such a freaking strong point. Does anybody think that Max has like massive rage, or is it just me? Because it looks like he always wants to beat the shit out of somebody. The way that Max and Patty were roughing it for the night, man. You know, I don't know, man. Should Max forgive him for that? That's 6 years of freaking work, man. He put his life, you know, sweat and tears into that drawing, which I thought was pretty darn cool. So him burning it up was definitely hilarious. Because you know, you have Max be like, hey, what you burning, babe? You know, what you using, pretty much. And yeah, it's his freaking book. So I felt a little bit bad for him. And Max had me a little bit of feeling all cheesy and sappy, you know, with his story, finding love and stuff like that. Definitely feel bad for Tina. You know, my heart was breaking inside. So, you know, this show definitely has a lot of laughs going on here, but you feel a lot of different things. But the music, man, is so on point that, it just amps me up. So, oh man. So I was like amped up this whole episode. You know, a little nod to, you see some of the Phoenix Knight characters. So we haven't seen them in a while. So definitely kind of cool, you know, rehashing and seeing some, Phoenix Knight moments there. Overall, I enjoyed the episode very much. Man, this is one of those shows, I'm going to be honest with you guys, that I feel like, I know how some shows go a little longer. I almost wish it was a little longer than the 20-something minutes. I don't know. Like, when you're just enjoying a show, you just want to see more and more. So, like, just going into this episode knowing that I don't have much to watch, like, I'm sad. I'm excited to watch it, of course, but I feel, like, a little bit bummed out. Anybody, you know, share that sentiment right there? Six episodes can't go by quickly, so I'm it's, like, bittersweet. But, Max and Patty, definitely some badass characters, you know. I got to watch out more for Max, man. He's going to beat the shit out of somebody. He just got a bad feeling, because he's the type of guy that definitely feels like he got some rage moments there. But, yeah, Patty, definitely one of my favorite characters, hands down, you know, just based off the personality. So, with that being said, did you guys enjoy the episode? If you had a favorite scene, feel free to say it. I will never think about Willy Wonka again after today. I'm going to do my best to forget it, but definitely hilarious. So loving it. We'll continue watching it. I just want to thank you all for the love and support. We will see you next time. Thanks so much for watching. Peace.